When I opened my mailbox yesterday, I had a wow moment, and I kind of wanted to take this opportunity to share it with you. I got in the mail MagPi number 40. This is the Raspberry Pi Community Magazine. This particular issue is special because it has a Raspberry Pi Zero on the front cover. That's the newest Raspberry Pi. I think that this is a piece of publishing and computer history. Which is why I haven't yet taken it out of the bag. I'm keeping it in the bag. I'm gonna see if I can find myself another copy that I can actually flip through and use the Raspberry Pi Zero. This one, I'm preserving this one because I think it's so neat. It's so neat to have this, and it'll be neat to show this to people years from now because I think this really represents a huge paradigm shift in computing. The fact that computers can be so small and so affordable. And it's really getting people to think about what a computer is and what a computer could be in the future. So I've actually had a Raspberry Pi Zero for a little while. I was working on a project for this issue of MagPi. I created a GPS logger. So you connect a USB GPS receiver to it. There's a quick script that runs on here to get that data, save it to a comma-separated value file. What's neat is that then you can plug the Raspberry Pi into a TV and then view the tracks, view your path on the screen, using just free open source software that's available for download. So for makers, I think that Raspberry Pi is an awesome product. You can connect components directly to it. You can solder components, you can solder circuit boards to it. Really, really cool. The small size will make a small computing projects much more easy to do. The price is also fantastic. You can dedicate a computer to a project and it's not going to be that expensive. So yeah, this is absolutely fantastic. This is a huge paradigm shift, and I'm really, really excited to see what people do with it. In the magazine, I also have a column which is talking about how its small size, its sort of maker-friendly features, and its price are a big deal. And while there are a lot of really cool things to do with Pi Zero, I would say right now, my favorite thing to do is just to show it to people, put it in their hands, and say, this is a computer, because it really changes everything. And so it's really exciting to experiment with it. I'm curious to know what people out there are going to do with it. We've already seen some amazing projects. But anyway, if you want to check out the project and you want to check out the column, you can actually download all issues of the MagPi for free as a PDF. Just go to raspberrypi.org/magpi. And you can download the PDF of all the issues, including this one, so you can check out what projects we're doing. And there's some great articles about Raspberry Pi Zero in there. So do check those out. Yeah, I'm curious to know if any of you have Raspberry Pi Zeros yet. I know there's a little bit of a backorder condition right now, but hopefully they'll be getting out there in the next few months. If you don't have one, I'm curious to know what you'd like to do with it. See you later.